Blackstone Publishing presents This Stops Today. Eric Garner's mother seeks justice after losing her son, by Gwen Carr, with Dave Smitherman. This book is read by Myra Lucretia Taylor. Every time you see me, you want to harass me. You want to stop me. I'm so sick of it. I'm minding my business, officer. I'm minding my business. Please just leave me alone. I told you the last time, please just leave me alone. I did not do anything. Please. Please don't touch me. Do not touch me. I can't breathe. Eric Garner. In memory of Erica Garner. Erica, you are my son's first child, my first grandchild. I just can't come to grips with you being gone so soon. It seems you were here but a day, and now you're gone away. But your fight for your dad will live on in me, and so will my love for you and yours. Mrs. Carr's incredible strength in the face of tragedy is monumental and awe-inspiring. Though there are dark days, she continues to fight for the rights of victims everywhere. She was thrust into action because she had to. She did it for Eric. The fight for justice continues. Viola Davis and Julius Tenen, co-producers of the TV docuseries, Two Sides.
Forward. Hillary Rodham Clinton. The writer Elizabeth Stone says that having a child is forever deciding to have your heart go walking around outside your body. Those words were echoing in my mind the day I first met Gwen Carr and the other mothers of the movement. Over iced tea at the Sweet Maple Cafe on Chicago's West Side, I listened to the stories of these broken-hearted mothers. Despite living through every parent's worst nightmare, they radiated strength and quiet, fierce dignity. Their stories and their strength have stayed with me ever since. So has Gwen's declaration that she intended to turn her sorrow into a strategy and her mourning into a movement. By channeling her private pain into public activism and sharing her truth in the pages of this book, that's exactly what she has done. It's easy to feel overwhelmed by all that's happening in our country, especially now. To read one heartbreaking headline after another and start to think, there's nothing I can do, and it hurts too much to even try. But we cannot grow weary of doing good. Just think of Gwen's resolve, her resilience, and her refusal to give up. She has endured some of the most painful circumstances imaginable. The excruciating loss of her firstborn, attempts to silence her voice, inaction from her own government, even attacks in the media. Yet far from growing weary, she is doing everything she can to make our country a better place. As Gwen writes of her journey from quiet grandmother to unlikely activist, I didn't know if I could make a real difference, but I did know that I could try. And so can we all. From the title to the final page, Gwen's book is a powerful call to action for our country. It's also a deeply personal story that any parent can relate to. The story of a proud and loving mother determined to fight for her son. It can be a daunting challenge to pour your heart onto the page, to write candidly and courageously about things you may never even have spoken out loud. But with her trademark eloquence, Gwen bravely shines a light on her own doubts, her struggles, and her quest to push through her limits and pain as a woman in her golden years who would rather be at home in her recliner. Not only that, but she also summons the generosity to share her son Eric with the world. He was much more than just a black man in a viral video. He was a caring, compassionate man who had love as wide as the ocean. Knowing Gwen is a gift, and so is reading this book. I am grateful every day to Gwen for her friendship and for her willingness to share her ideas and perspective with me, with the same honesty and eloquence that radiates from these pages. These are complicated issues. But, as Gwen points out, it's our responsibility to figure out what each of us can do to contribute. In our current political climate, reading and sharing books like Gwen's and adding our voices to hers is even more vital. And while progress is still too slow, when the opportunity arises to move forward and create real change, the policy principles Gwen has laid out in this book are a fantastic place to start. In the meantime, each of us owes it to Gwen and the mothers of the movement to ask what we can do in our own lives, to follow Gwen's lead, and refuse to grow complacent. At a minimum, we can start by facing hard truths, confronting our own implicit biases, and finding the courage to speak out. And we can try harder to walk in one another's shoes. That means police officers and all of us doing everything we can to understand the effects of systemic racism that young Black and Latino men and women face every day, and how they are made to feel like their lives are disposable. It also means imagining what it's like to be a police officer, kissing his or her kids and spouse goodbye every day, and heading off to do a dangerous but necessary job. That kind of radical empathy isn't easy to come by in a time when divisions in our country run as deep as they do today. But I am convinced that it's what we need, now more than ever before. The stories of the mothers and others who have lost loved ones to gun violence and police incidents deserve to be told and heard. As Gwen writes, our children were people with hopes and dreams just like anyone else, and they deserve to be remembered for more than just their violent ending. We have got to keep saying their names. Eric Garner, Sandra Bland, Michael Brown, Jordan Davis, Dontre Hamilton, Blair Holt, Trayvon Martin, Tamir Rice, Hadia Pendleton, the list goes on. This cannot be seen as a political issue. It can and must be seen as an issue of fundamental justice and basic human decency. We should insist on nothing less from politicians, candidates, and anyone hoping to lead. The killing and mistreatment of young Black men and women has been the reality of life in America for too long. But we can't accept it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.